Hello students, my dear friends, I am Pavan Kumar, assistant professor. Today I am going to deal with a subject called machine drawing. Why actually machine drawing? Why I have chosen this topic? Actually, I have an experience of more than 8 years, and what I have found in students is they confuse. They will be in a dilemma that where to start a specific drawing, where to start, where to end is a very big question mark. And moreover, they will be in a confusion that why actually machine drawing? Why it is required in engineering practice? No faculty will explain all these points in the classroom. They actually go on to the drawing, actual drawing. They'll ask them to draw the drawing based on the specifications given. That's it. They don't even talk about the application point or how to start the drawing, how to end the drawing. At the end of the drawing, what we need to do, what actually, how to give the units, how to give the scaling. They won't discuss all the points in actual practice. So here I'm going to make the subject more easier, more simplified, more interesting, only for the students' sake. Why actually machine drawing? Why is a question mark. If you see industrially, being a mechanical engineer, we need to deal with many materials. We need to deal with many components, many different components. For example, I'll name it as a basic nut, basic bolt, or type of thread, or a riveted joint, or a welding joint. You might have heard, but you haven't seen how the drawing is going to be of so and so X component. And the coming to the application point, there are many applications. Without machine drawing or without drawings, a component can't be manufactured. Unless a drawing is drawn on a draft sheet, it can't be fabricated. Here I'm going to cover, in this video, I'm going to cover some basics, fundamentals, before going on to the main topic. In this, we are going to cover some series of videos where you come across many topics based on your syllabus. So machine drawing, here I'm going to talk about representation of materials. Conventional representation of materials. The subject is completely scoring subject, where most of the students will feel that it is a tough subject, which is not. Conventional representation of materials. Actually, as I said, we deal with many types of materials. For example, I'll name it as cast iron, mild steel, maybe wood, copper, glass. Likewise, we have many other materials where we need to deal with. So what actually conventional representation? Here conventionally we'll try to represent a material with our own specifications. For example, if I want to show a cast iron cutted piece, I'll try to draw a rectangle and I'll try to do hatching like this. You might have seen in your classrooms or in your drawing halls. So why we do this? Why? What actually it means? It will maintain an angle of 45 degrees, as you all know, and there is a offset distance of 2. If the component size increases, then no need to draw an offset distance of 2 mm. You can go up to 3 mm, 4 mm, not a problem. It all depends on the size of the component you are dealing with. Okay, now here I have maintained an offset distance of 4 mm with an angle of or inclination of 45 degrees. It is not 45 all the time. It all depends on material to material. It may change to 60 degrees also. It all depends. When we go on to the actual topic, we'll discuss them all. But actually, these lines indicate that it is hatching or hatched portion. Why we do hatching? Why hatching is required? For example, there is a component. There is a 3D model, as you could see. There is a 3D model which is sectioned from top to bottom. Means the component is now into two pieces. What do we try to do? We'll try to remove the front piece and the back piece will remain. Now the remaining portion should get hatched, something like this. If it is made of cast iron, the hatching pattern or the style is different. If it is made of wood, the hatching pattern or the style again changes. If it is glass, again there will be a pattern given. So for a specific component or a material, specific material, the pattern will change, keep on. Okay. So whenever you section a component, you need to hatch the component. Fine. Now that indicates that it is made of so and so material, maybe cast iron, maybe wood, maybe mild steel. So here the question is, how does it help in engineering practice or in drawing big engineering drawings, machine components? It helps you in many ways. You can differentiate materials. For example, we'll take an example of an assembly. I'll take one box which is made of maybe cast iron, okay, and one more component which is placed over, which is made of mild steel, and these two got fixed with the help of some nut arrangement, nut and bolt arrangement. Fine. Now this nut is made of some, again, let us take an alloy, some other alloy, mild steel, some other grade 1. Let us take this grade as 2, cast iron. Now the nut is again made of mild steel grade 1. Okay. Now here you could see 1, 2, 3, 4 components. Okay. Now the 4 components are not made of same single material. So what happens in such cases, when you cut the model from top to bottom, when you cut the model from top to bottom with a cutting plane, what you call, then what happens? All the components will cut from top to bottom. It will pierce off. So what happens in such cases? You need to represent them all. So the representation going to be something like this. We draw both the components with a bolt with some hatching, maybe cast iron with this inclination of 45 degrees, maybe mild steel with some other 45 degrees, minus 45 degrees inclination. And if the nut and bolt or a riveted joint, rivet will also cut in some cases. Few things will not get hatched. Note, few things need to be noted. What are those in case of hatching? Here comes, like, when you cut a nut, when you cut a bolt or else a rivet or a threading, if you cut these components also in an assembly, we are not supposed to hatch them. We are not supposed to hatch these components, which is mandatory. Now we are going to hatch only the materials, not these fasteners or the components which will make the component assemble. Okay, if we cut the component also, we are not supposed to hatch these type of components. Okay, now why we do hatching or why we do sectioning? Hatching is okay to differentiate the material or else to differentiate the component. We'll try to do the hatching. That is okay, but why we do sectioning? Why sectioning is required? When you deal with an assembly, you come across many components. You come across the component which are intricate, which are inside the component, which are completely not visible to the observer. Maybe if you take a car engine, contains many cylinders, many setups, many arrangements. All the things can't be seen from the top of the car. If you open the bonnet also, you can't see the internal parts or intricate shapes or components of a engine, where you need to disassemble them all, which is not possible in case of drawing. So what we try to do, we'll try to do show with a section view, sectional view, what you call. When you cut the model, internal shapes or internal intricate shapes, internal components can be shown externally with the help of sectioning. That is the reason we do section the component. That is one case. After sectioning, we need to hatch, saying that the component has been sectioned. And it all depends on the material also. The component which you are going to cut, it, whether it is made of mild steel or wood or glass, that we need to represent with the help of conventional representation of material. With the help of what? Conventional representation of materials. Fine. What does this indicate? Conventional means we don't consider dimensions. Standard dimensions, what you call. We don't consider any standard dimensions. We only focus on how to show the representation of a material with the help of hatching. For example, a rectangular box I have considered before, you can hatch like this, the way I said before. Okay, it is not compulsory to use a rectangular box all the time. You can go with a square box also, you can go with a circle also, not a problem. You can draw an elliptical shape also. Okay, in that elliptical shape, you show your representation hatching, which are maintaining an angle of 45 degrees with an offset value of 2 angle of what? 45 degrees. To draw this simple sketch also, most of the students will get confused. How to draw this 45 degrees angle is a very big question mark for them. In spite of having drafter, protractor with them, they'll get confused, like where to start, where to end, how to take the angle. Your drafter will read few specifications. Your drafter will be something like this. Your drafter will be something like this, okay, which will have scaling arrangement, which will have angular arrangement also, which will read 0 to 90, 0 to 360 degrees, you can read it out. Fine. Now, if this scale, horizontal scale, if you align to your horizontal edge of your drawing sheet, it will maintain 45 degrees, minus 45, you'll come down. Okay. Now, only focus on the horizontal scale, not on a vertical scale. Okay, only focus on horizontal scale, where you could see your angle from 0 to 45, 0 to 90, whatever you want to measure. Okay, now for example, this is the box in which I need to hatch with an angle of 45 degrees with an offset of 2m or 3m. Okay, now align your drafter to 45 degrees, which you could see horizontal line. Now the horizontal is maintaining angle of 45 roughly. Okay, tighten the knob which is provided already on the drafter. Okay, now make markings on your box. For example, if you want to maintain an offset distance of 2m, make it as 2 4 6 8 10 12 14 16, like this. Okay, then align your drafter onto that particular dot. Align your drafter on that particular dot and draw parallel lines 1 2 3. Just move your scale, move your drafter scale on these dots. 3 4 5 6 7. Similarly on the vertical, 2 4 6 8. 1 2 3 4. This is how we'll draw. In actual practice, what the students do, they'll just draw a box, a rectangular box, perfect, not a problem. Then directly they'll maintain angle of 45 and then directly they'll try to draw these lines. How you maintain this offset, which is a question mark again. Maintaining that offset of 2m exactly all the time is not possible unless you make markings on the horizontal and vertical line. So make markings on the horizontal and vertical lines, align your drafter to 45 degrees, then draw parallel lines, simple. Okay, theta is equal to 45 degrees. These angles will change and the representations will also change and the patterns will also change. That we'll see in the conventional representation of material, which is our next lecture. Okay, this is the introduction about machine drawing. Application point is very big, and which without which there won't be any proper mechanical or mechanical component drawings in an industry, which is a very much important subject, which is very much scoring subject. Kindly focus more and series of lectures in the upcoming days. Thank you.